Uganda Wildlife Education Center is set to open conservation centers in regional cities as a way of promoting domestic tourism. The center's executive director, James Musinguzi, hopes this will reduce the cost of, the cost and promote domestic tourism in Uganda.
If there's a lesson COVID-19 has taught Uganda's tourism industry, is the dangers of relying on foreigners as tourists. When COVID-19 hit last year, tourism was one of the worst hit sectors as the countries closed their gates to stop the spread.
Been adversely affected by COVID-19. In terms of revenue, we have lost about 7 billion shillings for the financial year that has just ended, financial year 2020-2021. We lost about 7 billion shillings. And visitation went down drastically to about 25%.
The Uganda Wildlife Education Center says it has hatched a plan that it expects to boost domestic tourism as the sector rises from the ruins of the current pandemic.
We are now in the process of setting up regional wildlife conservation education centers in the regions of Uganda. We are going to set up in northern Uganda, eastern Uganda, western Uganda, where we are going to set up mini zoos. Zoos that can be able to carry out conservation education and promotion of domestic tourism in the various regions of Uganda. COVID-19 has taught us that we must promote domestic tourism as opposed to depending on the foreigners.
James Musinguzi, the center's executive director, says each of these regional zoos is expected to give a semblance of what happens at the National Center in Entebbe. The first of these regional zoos will be developed in Mbale City this financial year at an estimated 11 billion shillings. These will be stocked with different plants and animals found in different parks in the country. The initiative is also geared towards reducing the cost of tourism for Ugandans.
The clientele that do come to UWEK Entebbe comes from all over the country and has become unsustainable. It's very expensive. So people in West Nile, for example, somebody travels all the way from Koboko to Entebbe, it's not cheap. And so in order for them to get these services, we have been approached several times by the different Ugandans in the different regions. The school groups, for example, when they resume studying, not all of them can afford to come to Entebbe. If they have a regional zoo, because zoos are aimed at educating the public.
Before COVID, tourism was Uganda's highest foreign exchange earner, ranking in $1.6 billion in financial year 2018-2019. Musinguzi says they have seen rising visitor numbers at the center.
During COVID-19, we lost visitation up to 82%, where we were only receiving 18% of the visitors that we had budgeted to receive during the year. So we were hard hit. And of course, we have just come out of a lockdown now. We are just trying to monitor the numbers so that we can determine how many are coming.
We wait to see the magic that the planned regional zoos add to the domestic tourism touch. Story by Benon Ojambo and Titus Kakembo for the news.